Powering on. Mic on. Charge complete.
Black flag. You didn't exit the pit safely. We're gonna hold you for a while. That's it, go!
Mic off.
Thank you.
stopping, fella. Green, 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 green. Put in plenty of fuel to finish the race. The estimated SOF is 2,586. There are a lot of points on the table. Be smart and get a good finish. you have two additional sets of tyres for this race. Be smooth and have a good run. Line up on the outside. Pit road's closed, don't come in. Catch the pace car.
Radio check. Clear.
All good.
Stand by. You don't need luck. You just need skills. I wish that was the case. Yeah, you honestly need more luck here than anything.
Control.
Oh, 100%. Copy. Yeah, on the initial start, you have to wait for the green.
Can anyone around me check my front bumper to see the mic?
I can. Yeah, wait till the start-finish line, and then let this 34 by. I have one car behind him, and then I'll let you know. That way you don't get a black.
The road is now open.
That's a little sensible. Honestly, my mirror, it looks brand new. I don't think you have any damage.
Alright, thank you.
So is it just me, or does iRacing need to adjust, like, the incident system on short tracks?
I think they should lower it a little bit, kind of like dirt does, like a 4X becomes a 2X.
Here's my reasoning. Say the one car checks up in front of me and I barely touch him. I've noticed a lot this week that if I barely nudge him, like, it's not even going to give us damage, but it'll give us a 4X.
Road's closed, don't come in.
Like, barely touching him. Yeah, dude, it's like that on the plate track, too. It's like whatever they change, because during the 500 weekend, I was doing an NIS, and I gave somebody a push, and got a 4X for it, and I didn't hit him hard at all. So I think it's just something wrong with the whole system in general. Now, I know it'd be really hard to do, but I wish that they would almost come up with like a fault system. You know, like how in late model racing and stuff like that, if you are the car on the inside and you're behind the door and you rest, you know, that's on you. But if you're the car up in front, someone hits you from behind, you know.
One lap to green, line up on the inside.
Yeah, I mean, that would be pretty hard to do. The only thing that really sucks is, like, the transfer 4Xs. Like, somebody's trying to miss a wreck, and they hook a right on me, and I had nothing to do with it. They, you know, barely touch me, and I get a 4. Then again, my buddy is still pissed off at iRacing, hasn't painted the walls at Vegas yellow yet. So, I think with this new merger, though, with that game that they got coming out, they might have to update a whole bunch of
stuff. The pace speed until the restart zone. Then go.
sorry about putting it up in the field there, fellas. Didn't really have a choice. I got left reared and then hit the pit wall, and I had it hooked left the whole time and just shot me back up into the field.
That's where this whole shit happened.
Worst part about it though is I literally didn't even hit anyone. Which I don't think.
Catch the pace car. Catch the pit car.
Yeah, I just feel bad because I bitch about everybody else holding the brakes, and of course, the one time I get wrecked here, nothing I can do about it, and I kill everybody. Again, my apologies, guys.
Honestly, Tyler, you should have just held the brakes, bro.
Mike on.
Oh, missed pit road trying to uncheck tires. Look at that. Oh yeah, I cannot turn. I'd suggest just trying to stay as far away from me as possible until I can get in pit road. It's all over the place when I hit the gas.
Catch the pace car.
Hey man, I agree. This thing probably drives better than Ty's car did in practice though.
As long as it's got less than 3 minutes of optional, I'd say run it.
Pit road's closed, don't come in.
William, I'm with you there, man. I'm with you, William. A lot of people are saying it's his car and it's Allen, from what I've heard, but I love Chase, but I think it's mostly just him, man.
Thank you for Bowman. Growing from leading the points 5 weeks in to breaking his back and not being able to get the feel of the car.
One lap to green. Line up on the inside.
I really like Bowman, but that's always been his kind of thing. He's never really been the big, you know, go out and dominate races type. I mean, Kyle Busch said it best. He literally backs into race wins. I know Bowman's got a big contract, but it would not surprise me if he's not around at Hendrick for a couple more years.
You have control. Maintain the pace speed until the race starts.
I think he'll always be around because of Ally. Like, Ally's not going to sit there and force Hendrick to get a better driver.
23.
Everyone go high. Go high right here, guys. Go high.
Woo! Catch up.
Damn, man. Y'all wait to have the longest green flag run of the weekend for me to be wrecked.
I don't know where to be.
Yeah, I'm going to say I waited about 20 laps and I thought, fuck it, we're going to get a caution here eventually. So I put my hammer down.
Pit road is open.
I mean, I'm sitting here like, okay, maybe I'll still have a little bit of a chance. You know, we'll keep having a wreck there.
Nope. Fast on the outside. Boxing 10, 5, 3, 2, 1. Right here. And let go. Just be mindful, you only have one set of tires remaining. Line up, single file. Catch up, and jump, half up, and jump.
God, I almost got him. Hang on, William, I'll let you down.
Catch up, and
no, I'm talking about how, like, the walls in Vegas and stuff haven't been redone. I read something that said with the new games, they're going to use, like, tractors and stuff that's already in iRacing. Which, I mean, would assume that they'd have to update the iRacing track, that way they're accurate on the game.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about earlier. They've never done it, but apparently when the new game comes out, they're going to use everything that's on iRacing, but they're going to have to update everything. So,
I mean, New Hampshire Motor Speedway still has the Turn 3 and 4 grandstands, which were removed in 2019.
You know what, screw it. They just need to redesign New Hampshire and put the start-finish line in the middle of 3 and 4.
One last dream, get ready. Line up on the inside.
Might as well.
Let's do everything we get a Phoenix everywhere! Now we're on the start-finish line at Bristol is on pit road and pit road only.
Put the draft package on him in New Hampshire and let him run.
Give him just fucking little wall casters, little silver casters on like a toolbox and plug them with the wall. Cross that lane style.
You have control. Maintain the pace speed and
we got some fight back here.
Then go.
Nah, probably not in iRacing, but I'm like, this is not a guy with like an aspect from the side, you know.
It road is open.
Well, I think it would be possible. It could just do like one of those things, kind of how NASCAR 13 did with the pit. And then as you get closer, you just do like left or right on the D-pad, on the
outside. I imagine it would be something like that. Like NASCAR 15, if you were the leader, you could select the inside and outside lane. I imagine they would just give you like a number of how many cars in front of you are going outside and inside, and then they would just let you pick. Also, I didn't speed in the pits. I really maximized getting in the box. Like, my brake bias is at 39%, and so I was basically almost in my box before the brake to go down.
Lift up 22, job on.
And then I had a really good launch. I just pulled 3,000 RPM with no clutching up, and as soon as it allows me to go, I just take off with no wheel spin or nothing.
I mean, I really think they should have a 9-degree with it. I mean, people are going to have to get used to it at some point. They would add a lot more strategy, especially to some of these tracks, but there's no path that you could dip.
Now, to make it even better, Austin, I didn't even go through the pit boxes. If I would have went through the pit boxes, and I would have squeezed that 3 and 4 a little bit tighter, I would have beat the 18 out. He beat me by like 2 or 3 inches.
Pit road closed.
But, Tyler, to get back to what you were saying, if they threw those stupid restart zone crap in here, the way that it is now, I mean, I don't know, it wouldn't surprise me if they threw the cheese zone in here eventually.
I mean, as stupid as people might think the cheese ball is, if we're talking about, you know, realistic simulation.
I mean, it's not a game. It's a simulator. I mean, and they do it in real life, so, dot.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to be one of those guys, but I'm just saying that they're going to,
One lap to green, get ready, line up on the
outside. I mean, it's a simulator, don't get me wrong, but at the same point in time, it's also a fucking video game.
Yeah, like I said, I'm not one of those guys who, somebody calls it a video game, I'm like, I can care less. I'm just hitting.
It seems like a lot of the newer people kind of treat it as a video game, so I'm almost all of that at times.
The lead on control, maintain the pace speed, the door is start zone, then go.
Nice.
Oh my, you are not in danger, get over it. I saw you coming.
I mean, you came up right in front of us. They told me to catch the 10, and if I didn't lift to not hit you, I mean, dot.
Dot, yellow.
Dot, I was supposed to catch a 10 car. Only until I stopped and I let you go, he's going to stay behind the 19.
Man, supposed to catch me. Good lord.
I don't know how I'm going to do it, Tyler. You're too fucking fast, bro.
Yeah, man, I put the new setup in with a wheel 180.
Got the lucky dog.
Flying.
Passed on
the outside.
How many options you got left?
Oh, I'm completely fixed. I had to completely fix it to even be able to drive it around here.
Go slow.
Lift up 10. Job on.
It ain't too bad. Looks like mostly just the left rear.
Yeah, wheel 180 though.
Hey, just play with the steering offset, hey. .180 degree steering wheel, honestly, bro, that sounds like a setup problem to me.
Oh, yeah. We didn't have it dialed in. We brought it to the racetrack. ...180 may be a little bit of an exaggeration, but it's at least 90.
Pit road's closed, don't come in.
Dog, we got a 0x because I was checking up. I could have just ran you over and never even tried to touch the brake.
Hey William, I'm sorry for flying up into you on the last one. Kyle, your car looks like it's painted up like a cat dozer, and your front end is pushed in the middle, and it looks like the front loader of a cat dozer. It's honestly kind of funny.
You're all good, Ryan. No hard feels.
Car, well, got the lucky dog. Let them pass on the outside.
That's what my 4X was from before. The other person is not checking out the part of the rear.
Yeah, I bet. You're all good, man. I had it locked up from the time I saw myself all the way there. It took that long to stop.
Well, it's telling me to let you go.
Go ahead, bro.
Hey, I'm trying to finish the race too. Dude, I'm riding around here so slow. If I get involved in a wreck, there's something wrong.
Road closed.
2. I'm going to be down here on the anthem just waiting on you to go by.
Carbine. Green next time by. Line up on the outside.
What are the odds we go green to the end? Let's go 10 to 1.
Slip to the... I feel like it's almost even odds that we have to leave
ahead of control. Maintain the pace speed until the start zone, then go.
Left down trying to force it 3 every restart.
It is, yeah. There's really no word for that.
Oh, there's a word for it. We're just gonna get chat banned if we say it.
Yeah, I can't afford that. I need my voice.
You really think I plan on shutting up either?
Hey, Ken, how bad is the rear?
Pit road is now open.
Doesn't look bad. Right there in the center under the Toyota logo, it looks like somebody beat it with a hammer. And then just to the left of the hammering,
the lucky dog,
it's like disconnected
from
the spoiler, but...
Are we talking like a ball peen hammer, or are we talking like a full-on sledgehammer?
Like a ball peen hammer. If you look at the back of the car, it's probably about that, maybe a little bit less.
Yeah. Well, now that was a...
10 laps to go, fella.
That's great.
10 laps to go, fella.
I'm just going to say it because I'm feeling ballsy and I'm going to say it, and I got a wood table right next to me that I'm knocking on as we speak. I only have 4 incident points. Well, I'm going to be honest with you, I'm averaging 16 so far this week, so...
Pit road closed.
Well, I also haven't qualified for a single race this week. So, maybe if I qualified and I wasn't in the shit show, it would be a little different.
Man, it doesn't matter if you qualify or not. I've qualified up front, qualified in the middle, qualified in the back. You always either wreck somebody or get caught up in somebody else's mess. Like, in this race, I didn't do anything. They just wrecked behind me and we split back up the trip.
My normal philosophy is always just save tires, and then at the halfway point, just go as hard as I can.
Green next time by.
But, I mean, I can't drive through any wreck here. It's like, the track's blocked as soon as you get a free car in.
Go one more lap. Go one more lap.
Got a delay to green to that, really?
Huh?
16, most of your damage seems to be on, like, the left rear quarter. It's kind of separated a little bit.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
Green next time by. There's a little bit of a difference between a bump and run and almost wrecking somebody off their left rear.
I mean, I got no problem with bumping and running. Like, if he wanted to bump me in the fence, I would have been fine if he hit me in the Camaro and put me up in the fence. I would have been fine with that. But hitting someone in the left rear, that's just intentionally spinning them. No, I'm not happy. I think I had a better car than you. And you literally had to wreck me. So no, I'm not happy. But if that's how you want to race, okay, I'll see you in the next one. Yeah, in 20 laps, I think I did have a better car.
Only thing I could maybe say is maybe the one car came down just a little bit, but I don't know, I'm not going to get involved in it. charge, is it? 8? Whatever. That is true, it is Bristol.
Because they were restarting in first gear, I didn't notice it. Man, they're restarting. When the third place car got up to my door, I was like, all right. I had tried it once, but just... today, and there was a dude that ran about a fucking 14.2, and he was on the track, and I just went and watched about a lap, and I was like, oh, that dude has got it stuck.